हेलो स्टूडेंट्स, माई सेल्फ साकेश रंजन श्रीवास्तव, साइंस टीचर इन संत माइकल्स एकेडमी। इन दिस पार्ट ऑफ वीडियो आई टीच द स्टूडेंट्स ऑफ क्लास 6 एंड ऑल्सो द नेम ऑफ चैप्टर इज हैबिटेट ऑफ द लिविंग थिंग्स। इन दिस पार्ट ऑफ वीडियो वी ऑल स्टडी अबाउट फूड चेन, रूल ऑफ एबायोटिक कंपोनेंट्स, वाटर एंड वाटर साइकिल इन डिटेल्स। सो नाउ आई स्टार्ट अबाउट दिस चैप्टर। फर्स्ट टॉपिक फूड चेन। वी ऑल स्टडी अबाउट फूड चेन। द फ्लो ऑफ एनर्जी थ्रू फूड ऑकर्स फ्रॉम प्लांट टू हर्बीवोरस एंड आफ्टर देम कार्निवोरस एंड फाइनली टू डिकम्पोजर्स। दिस चेन ऑफ ट्रांसफर ऑफ एनर्जी इज कॉल्ड फूड चेन। फूड चेन मीन्स डिफरेंट टाइप्स ऑफ लिविंग ऑर्गेनिज्म डिपेंड ऑन फूड वन इट टू अनदर फॉर गेनिंग एनर्जी फॉर सर्वाइवल। सो दिस ट्रांसफर ऑफ एनर्जी फ्रॉम वन एनिमल टू अनदर इज नोन एज फूड चेन। वेरियस टाइप्स ऑफ लिविंग ऑर्गेनिज्म प्रेजेंट ऑन द अर्थ सर्फेस एंड ऑल्सो वन इट अनदर एंड अनदर इट अनदर। इन दिस वे दे ऑल इट ईच अदर for gaining energy and this transfer of energy from one to another is known as food chain. Here is given the figure of a simple example of food chain, a food chain in nature. You will see here that grass is eaten by insect and also this insect eaten by frog and this frog eaten by snake and this snake eaten by eagle. So in this way one eat another for gaining energy. So transfer of energy occurs by this from one to another and this is also known as food chain. Now we all study about role of abiotic components. As you know, abiotic components means non-living things present on the earth surface. Without their cooperation, we could not survive on the earth surface. First important is soil. Soil is the topmost layer of the earth crust. And also, it is capable of supporting life and made from by crumbled rocks. And also by weathering of rocks, the soil formed over million of years by the help of wind and water and also other environmental conditions. Weathering of rocks means breaking down of rocks and after a long time of period, this also convert into soil. So soil play important role in survival of living organism on the earth surface. This is the figure which help in the formation of soil. Now next thing, usefulness of soil. Soil provide platform for the growth of plants. It provides water and minerals to the plant. It supports root of the plants. It is a living space for numerous microorganisms, as example bacteria and fungi and burrowing animals like worms. Now we all study about different types of soil. On the earth surface various types of soil also present. The first is called sandy soil. It has major proportion of sand particles. This type of soil is found in desert. It is poor in nutrients and cannot hold much water. So sandy soil is not suitable for agriculture. Now next, clay soil. It is formed mainly of clay particles. It can hold large amount of water. And also, clay soil is rich in minerals. It is good for cultivation. The root of plant don't get enough oxygen. Now, the merits of loamy soil. It is a mixture of sand, silt and clay, and also their water holding capacity is also very good. It is reasonably porous and contains plenty of air. This is the best soil for agriculture. Now, after different types of soils and their merit, we all try to know about water and water cycle. At first, water. Water is called the most important things present on the earth's surface. It is also said that water is life. Without water, nobody can survive on the earth's surface. And it is also said that water is a wonder liquid. Why? This is an important question. Why water is called a wonder liquid? Because water is the first thing present on the earth's surface in three states: solid, liquid and gaseous state. No any other substances except water present on the earth's surface which have these types of merit. And second thing, water is the important liquid which has capacity to dissolve large number of substances present on the earth's surface. These merits of the water makes it great on the earth's surface. Now, as you know, this water present on the earth's surface approximately 71%. And this water, large amount of water present in sea and oceans, and very few amount of water present in river, lakes and ponds. Water is also present in atmosphere in the form of water vapor, and also this water present under the ground in the form of underground water. And this water is essential for all the living beings present on the earth surface. And also it forms the major part of the body of all living beings. Most types of chemical reaction occurs inside our body only in the presence of water. We need water for various purposes, as drinking, cooking, cleaning, washing, and also production of electricity also, and also for agricultural point of view. Water body support a wide variety of organisms. They may be as big as whales or as teeny microorganisms. So, there is a great importance of water on the earth's surface. Now, next thing. Each and every living organism present on the earth's surface, they needed water every time, and without this, they cannot survive on the earth's surface. Then it is an important question. Maximum amount of water utilized by each and every living beings. Then there is a great scarcity of water occurs on the earth's surface. But not. Water is the wonder liquid, and also they always present on the earth's surface by different methods. And one important merit of water is we all know about this, that water cycle also maintain the water available on the earth surface every time. It is water cycle which play important role that we could not have a loss of the water on the earth surface. It means this water present on the earth surface every time by the help of water cycle. This is the figure of water cycle. You all seen this figure. Then the question is, what is water cycle? Water cycle, the constant circulation of water from earth's surface to atmosphere and again from atmosphere back on the earth's surface. This is called water cycle. In water cycle, by different water bodies, the water also utilized by living organism, and also by the process of evaporation, and also by the process of transpiration, they convert into water vapor and move in the atmosphere. and in atmosphere due to the process of precipitation. They convert in the tiny water droplets and makes the cloud. And this cloud falling down on the earth's surface in the form of rain. And this process is known as precipitation, evaporation, condensation and precipitation. There are three important points related to water cycle. Evaporation means water change into water vapor. Precipitation means water vapor change into tiny water droplets. And precipitation means falling down of rain on the water surface in the form of water, hails, hailstones, fog and snow. So these three methods including in the water cycle, and by this process this water does not loss on the earth surface, and every time they make their balance on the earth surface, so all the living organisms survive here for rain. So in this part of video I complete this video. Thank you.